Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Segmented Control. The .NET MAUI Segmented Control offers options from a linear set of segments containing text, images, or a combination of both. Each segment is represented as a discrete button, enabling users to make choices in an intuitive manner. In this video, I will show you how to add Syncfusion's .NET MAUI Segmented Control to a .NET MAUI project. I will demonstrate how to populate segment items with both text and images, select segments, disable items, and customize the appearance of segment items. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I select the .NET MAUI application. Then, provide the project name and location. I'll create a project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before I move forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the application's environment. Here, I select the Android emulator from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Once the emulator is selected, I will run the application and show you the default output. The application compiles a default code, so wait for a few seconds. And now, the application's homepage is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the segmented control into this application. First, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Buttons NuGet package. So, I open the NuGet Package Manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the MAUI Buttons package and select it to install in my project. Click Apply to continue the installation. Once the package is installed, I need to register the handler for Syncfusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. Open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI Core hosting namespace. Then, register the Syncfusion Core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion Core method. To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it is necessary to register a trial license key. So, I open the app XAML CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate a trial license key, click the link to the instructions in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. Remove the default code from the content page section. Then, import the Syncfusion MAUI Buttons namespace. I initialize the .NET MAUI segmented control. To add segment items, define the item source property. Inside this item source property, define an array of strings. In this example, I'll add different calendar views such as daily, weekly, monthly, and yearly. Now, let me run the application. As you can see, the control displays the calendar views on the emulator, and you can switch between views. Now, let me demonstrate how to populate segmented items with text and images. Before beginning, let me remove the item source property. To populate the items, create a new class named ViewModel to manage the segmented items. Make this class public and initialize its constructor. Then, define a new property named SegmentItems to hold the collection of segment items. Next, initialize a new instance for the SegmentItems property inside the constructor. Here, I'll add the items related to transportation, such as walk, bike, car, and bus. After that, navigate to the main page XAML to bind the items. Import the local namespace where the view model is located. and then set it as the binding context for the main page. Next, bind the segment items property to the item source property. Looking here, the options are now populated as segment items, allowing you to switch between them. Navigate to the View Model class to add image icons to the items. Define the image source property and set a new instance of font image source within the segment item element. Set appropriate values for the glyph, font family, and color properties. Here, the segmented UG icons font family is already added to the resources fonts folder. Similarly, add image source for the remaining segment items. You can observe that the transport options are now displayed with text and icons. Next, I'll demonstrate how to select segment items programmatically. To achieve this, navigate to the segmented control and set an appropriate value to the selected index property, for instance, 2. Before running, I'll remove the segment icon code changes added in the View Model class. As you can see, the third segment item is now selected based on the given index. To customize the selected items, define the Selection Indicator Settings property with a Selection Indicator Settings element. To customize the placement, you can set the Selection Indicator Placement property to Fill, Border, Top Border, and Bottom Border. Here, I set it to Top Border. The default value is Fill. Looking here, the Selection Indicator is now placed at the top. To change the border color, set the Stroke property to Dodger Blue and Stroke Thickness to 5. As you can see, the border is now in Dodger Blue color with modified stroke thickness. Next, let me show you how to disable segment items. Navigate to the View Model class. To enable or disable, set the IsEnabled property to True or False. Here, I will disable the walk and bus transport options. Before running, I'll remove the selection customization code changes in the main page XAML. See, the walk and bus options have been disabled. To customize the disabled segments, set the disabled segment background property to light gray. Next, set the disabled segment text color property to gray. Looking here, the background is light gray with gray text. Next, I'll show you how to customize segment items. To change the background, set the segment background property to light blue. To change the border, set the stroke property to blue and stroke thickness to 2. Before running the application, let me revert the disabled segment code changes. Now, the segments have a light blue background with a blue border. To learn more about the segments customization, refer to the documentation link provided in the description below. In this video, I have shown you how to add Syncfusion's .NET MAUI segmented control to a .NET MAUI project. I also showed how to populate segmented items with both text and images, select segments, disable segmented items, and customize their appearance. To learn more about the features of segmented control, you can check the documentation link provided in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.